Welcome to the advanced section of the QuickBooks for Home Finance course. In this section, we will learn about personal financial statements. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. This is the advanced section of the course because it is optional. That means that if you are satisfied with everything you've learned so far, you can stop now and be very happy with what you learned in the course. If you do not need to report your financial statements to anyone other than for taxes, then you do not need this section. However, if you choose to take this section, you do not need to know textbook accounting to be able to understand the remaining videos. You will learn some introductory accounting ideas along the way. They are easy to understand and they are common sense. So what are financial statements in the first place? Well, normally they would be reported about a business. They are documents and reports that show both how well the company is operating and what financial position the company is in at any given moment. So let's think first about how well the company is operating. The income and expenses of the company are compared to each other on a report called the profit and loss. It shows the operating income of the company versus the operating expenses. And when I say operating income, I mean the normal income from doing what they do to make money. And when I say operating expenses, I mean the normal reoccurring expenses that pay for the necessary things to be able to earn income. Then there are other income or expenses that do not affect the operating income, but changes the overall net income or net profit. And these are things that change the income that are not part of your normal operations. Now let's talk about the other report, the report that shows the financial position of the company. It's called the balance sheet, and it shows how much money or value the company has. It shows the value of everything the company owns. That means how much they paid for the assets. It also shows all the debts and obligations of the company and assigns a money value to those, and they are called liabilities. It shows the net worth of the company, and the net worth is defined in this lesson as the difference between the value of the assets that they own and the amount owed to the liabilities, which would make sense. Now, the profit and loss shows how well you did during a period of time. The balance sheet shows the current value of the company at any given moment. But where do they get their numbers from? All the numbers on both of these reports come from our good friend, the trial balance. After you run your trial balance, the income and expense accounts get transferred over to the profit and loss, and the assets and liabilities, which are the rest of the accounts in the trial balance, get placed on the balance sheet. For example, here's what a profit and loss would look like. And by the way, the profit and loss is also called an income statement. And if you look at the profit and loss from the file that you're in, you'll notice that the bartending income and the landscaping income are the same individual money amounts that you saw a moment ago in the trial balance. But on this profit and loss statement, we put all income accounts together to gain another number that shows on this report the total income. You may also notice that the individual expenses are the same numbers that they were a moment ago in the trial balance. But they're put together on the profit and loss in a category, and you get the total of the category. The total expenses are shown on the profit and loss. Then the profit and loss compares the total income to the total expenses to give you one final number, the net income. And the net income indicates how well you did during a particular period of time as a business or as an individual. The balance sheet is shown here. It shows the assets of the company and what you spent or how much they're worth at the moment that you're reporting the balance sheet. It shows any debt or liability that either the company or the individual has or really owes at the moment you run the balance sheet. And the difference is called the net worth. If it's a business, you would call it the owner's equity. If it's a person, you would call it the net worth. And not all balance sheets are in this format, but all balance sheets show the assets, liabilities, and the net worth of the company. And again, those numbers came from the trial balance, and they were summarized into the categories that you see here. So who needs to make financial statements in the first place? Well, companies and businesses must make financial statements in order to operate. But individuals, people, also need to make their own personal financial statements. And you may well ask, why would individuals need financial statements? Well, one reason is it will help you prepare for your taxes, so you have some sense of how much estimated taxes to send in, as well as how much you'll actually pay when you file. You may need to show personal financial statements to a bank or some lender if you're going to take a personal loan. You may need them for a marriage or divorce issues regarding community property. When a person passes away, their financial holdings and liabilities get transferred to another entity called an estate. An estate is actually a separate legal entity. It has its own assets, liabilities, net worth, income and expenses, and profit. They must be reported on financial statements in the same way that a business would need to. And these are the methods that accountants would use to manage an individual's estate even before a person may have passed on, so that when they do pass away, there's a clear accounting of every financial aspect of the person if there was a will or some kind of trust established from the estate. In fact, a trust fund is also a separate legal entity. It has its own assets, liabilities, net worth, income, expense, and profit. They must be reported on financial statements in the same way that a business would need to. And these are the methods that accountants would use to manage a trust, which is usually a contract established by an attorney or a notary. Both an estate and a trust could have income and expenses, not just a liability. For example, if the person who passed on had both a house and a mortgage, the house would be the asset, the mortgage would be a liability, and if they had tenants renting from them before they passed away, the tenants are still responsible for paying the rent, but the rent would go to the estate. If you make a trust fund that's represented by a bank account in the bank, and the bank earns interest, That interest would be income and would have to be recorded on an income statement or profit and loss, similar to the one that you saw a moment ago. So this is the reason why individuals have to do the same record keeping and same accounting as a business if they wish to report personal individual financial statements for any legal reason they might have. And that's the reason why I added this advanced section to the course. I hope you enjoy it as much as you've enjoyed the first part of the course, and I know that you will find it interesting and informative.